A few years back, I did a video review and tutorial on an app that I came across for iOS that allowed you to film yourself and read your script using a teleprompter at the same time. The app was called Video Teleprompter. Well, since then, the maker of that product, JoeAllen, has upgraded and updated the app, and there's now a version that's called Teleprompter Premium. In today's video, I'll do a new review and tutorial. Everybody that records videos while using their iPhone needs this app. So let's get started. So once you've downloaded the app from the App Store, you want to click on it. So you're clicking on this blue icon. So if this is your first time using the app, you can get into trying to see what it's all about by clicking on the demo. And in under the demo, you will see that there's already a text in there and there's a script that if you just touched your screen, you could scroll up and down and see what is on that or in that script. Or you can hit the blue start button and you can see how it's scrolling up. So what I want to do first is just kind of walk you through the principles of using the app, and then I'll show you how you can create your own script. So we're going to pause this or stop it by clicking the blue button again that said pause on it. So let's say, for example, you want to change the font, or maybe you want to adjust something with regards to the way that the background looks. If you are using your camera and you're going to have a lot of light behind you, you may not be able to see the screen as clearly if you don't do something with the opacity behind the text. So if you can kind of see, I'm a little bit dark, or at least seems that there's a little bit of a shade behind me, and that's because of the opacity. So to change the opacity, we're going to go down to the wheel icon in the bottom left corner. And that's the settings tool. And we're going to go scroll down to video recording. And when you click on that, there's text opacity. So if you want it to look darker, you can adjust it accordingly. And as you can see, you can barely see me now. And truth be told, you don't really need to see yourself thoroughly. I would use myself as just a gauge to make sure that I'm looking in the right spot. So for the direction that my camera and phone is in right now, it really is best if I'm looking straight ahead. Now, it is lower on me in this example, and I have it lower on me for a purpose, but if I wanted to raise it up, this would be more at eye level. And so right now I'm looking at the camera eye, which is right there. So it's just better for me to have it on my desk with the tripod so that I can have my hands free. So if you want to change the opacity, let's go back down here. If you want to change the opacity to totally clear, you can do that. And then now you can see me a little bit clearer. If you want to change the pace, if you feel that this pace actually looks pretty good. But if you decide that you want to change the pace of this, then you can simply change the pace by stopping or pausing and adjusting this gauge here, which takes you from turtle, which is super slow, to a hare, which is super, super fast. So if we moved it to about there, you will see, you'll see that it is a lot faster. Now, if you're a speed reader, you can have it go all the way, and then you can see it does go up a little bit faster. So you can hit pause. You can go back to the beginning of the script by hitting the icon or the arrow to the left. If you want to go to the end of the script, you hit the arrow to the right. I don't know why anybody would want to fast forward to the end, but that's what you can do. And then while you're playing it, if for whatever reason you wanted or needed to have it go backwards, you can have it do that. I don't know of anybody that reads backwards, but if you're one of those people and that's a special skill and talent that you have, then this app is going to be perfect for you. So let's go back to the settings button, and I want to show you how you can change your font and the size of your text. So if you want to change your font, you just click on the font that's selected, which is Helvetica. And then you can scroll through all of these fonts to choose a font that you would prefer to use. If you want to change the size, you can just use the plus or the minus in order to change the size of the font. Depending on whether you're having this landscape or portrait will determine which size font makes sense. So because I have it portrait, it's going to take a smaller font versus if I had it landscape, it would take a larger font. So let's go back under the settings. And I'm not going to worry about background for right now. Background just refers to, instead of it being like a black background, if you did not want to use your camera and you just wanted to use this as a teleprompter. So let's say, for example, you're recording yourself on another camera, but you want to use this one so that you can use it as a teleprompter only. You can change the background from black to green, white, whatever color it is that you want to use. This for margins, 40% is where the text is formatted right now. If you want to make it wider or to take up more real estate, if you will, on your screen, you can see that it's now the full width of the camera right now. So it's totally up to you where you want to have that. I'm not going to go through the mirroring because the mirroring is if you're going to use your phone as a standalone teleprompter or your iPad as a standalone teleprompter, because you're using your DSLR or you're using some other kind of camera to go along with it. So if you decide to use this as a teleprompter, you can disable your camera. And when you come back, you'll see now this is just the teleprompter by itself. And remember, I changed the background from black to green. This is how you're able to see it. To re-enable your camera, you have one of two ways you can do it. You can go back under the settings wheel and go back to video recording and then enable it, or you can simply hit on the camera icon. Now before, I don't know if you noticed, it was actually a red button. So let's click that back, hit done, and you see that it's a red button. To record yourself, once you're ready, you have your script in there, you're ready, you've practiced, then all you would have to do is hit the record button, and then you can start your teleprompter and you can start recording. As long as it's a red circle with a white square, you're recording. So when you stop recording, you hit the stop button and the teleprompter is going to keep going because that's separate. You can see that the video has been saved. So we're just going to stop for now. So now I want to go back actually and go to your scripts. So if you're ready to create your first script, what you can do is either manually compose your script within the app. It is a little, you know, if it's not a really long script, go for it. If it's going to be a lengthy script, unless you have really great thumbs and you're very nimble and you're very quick, then you can go ahead and do it this way. But if you decide to, you can do, see, I can't even type if I'm doing it on here. So you title it and then you type in, you say create script. And then now you have this here where you can copy and cut that or select it and cut it. And then you can start to type your script here. So you can type. Again, I told you my fingers are not nimble. Type your script here. That's a bit too much for me. So I wouldn't do that. The other option is to import it, and you can import it in a number of different ways. You can import it if you've already had a previous script that you've created, or you can import it through your iCloud account. So you can create what I do, which is my easiest way for me to do it, is I will write my script in notes on my iPhone, and then I will save it on my phone, and then I'll be able to copy it and paste it into the, I'll still go in with the script, or like I'm going to write a script, and instead I copy and paste it from notes. If I happen to have a document, I'm just fooling around and touching on a couple of different things. If I happen to have a document that's already in my iCloud drive, then I can just come to there, and then you saw that it just populated in there. So there are a number of ways that you can import, and it's just totally up to you and depending on where you have it. It could also be a document that's on your Dropbox, so you can feel free to grab it from there. So, but my favorite way, because I personally don't like having to type my scripts out. So what I like to do is I actually talk my scripts out in an app on my iPhone called Speechy, and it actually records my audio and it transcribes at the same time. So I use Speechy whenever I want to record my scripts. So instead of sitting down at my computer and typing out my scripts for my videos, I simply open up Speechy and I start to speak, period. So whenever I need to quickly create a script, this is the go-to app that I choose to use. And when I'm done, I can either send it to my Trello board, or maybe I might want to send it to Dropbox, or I simply come in here, copy, and then I paste it in Teleprompter Premium. I compose my script, and then I just simply paste it. And there you go. So that's my workaround. You might have a different workaround where you do like to actually write your scripts out. And if that's the case, then all you would need to do is upload it to your Dropbox and connect the app to your Dropbox, or connect your Dropbox to the app. And then you'll be able to access it from there. And as you saw, you just clicked on whatever the script was and it automatically imported itself into video teleprompter. From there, you adjust your margins, you adjust your fonts, you adjust the speed, and then you're good to go to record. So this is just a really simplified and easy way for you to be able to record yourself without having to worry about remembering certain things or anything like that. You can just literally hit the red button and then start recording with ease. I do still recommend that you do some practicing, because even for reading a teleprompter, it's not a natural thing for us to do. So it may take a few times of trying to do it before you're comfortable actually recording that way. So that's my recommendation for you. It's called Teleprompter Premium. It is available right now. It's on the App Store. It is for iOS and I believe Android. I could be wrong on the Android, so don't kill me if I am. There is potentially a way that you can access the record feature in this for free. I'm actually in communications with the owner of the app to confirm that, because I have been trying to see if there is a way for you guys to get access to this for free as opposed to paying, I think it's $14.99 in order to actually purchase it. But that's not a bad purchase price, because it's one time, you get it for free. He does a lot of updates and upgrades to the app during the time that you have it, and then you'll never have to pay for it again if he is consistently updating it. So I think 15 bucks personally is not a bad deal for what this app can do for you. But before I post this video, I'm going to make sure that it is available to you guys for free as well. And I'll give you all that information in the description below. All right, so take care. And I do want to hear your feedback. If you do decide to use this, I want to hear how it's been for you. What has been your take on using it? So let me know. So I'll talk to you later. Bye. Quick update, you guys. In order for you to activate the recording feature for free, which is available up until June 8th, after June 8th, you're going to have to pay. Once you enter the app, all you need to do is open up your script. You can either go down here to the settings wheel and scroll down to video recording. You can enable your camera there, or you can go to the camera icon on the bottom right and enable the camera there. Once the camera is enabled, then you will see that it's turned into a red dot. Once you click on that red dot, you'll see that you can record. So that's how you'll be able to access the recording feature for free. You simply just have to go into settings for your camera and enable it. Okay? So have fun, you guys.